Hi guys, in this session, let me discuss about what are the various sites where we encounter this Mickey Mouse sign. Mickey Mouse sign is encountered at various places in radiological imaging. The first place that I want you to remember the Mickey Mouse sign is progressive supranuclear palsy. Progressive supranuclear palsy is associated with midbrain atrophy. So the normal axial MRI of the brain, it shows healthy crust cerebri, the squarish crust cerebri, as well as the tactile area of the midbrain. And if you have a progressive supranuclear palsy, which is associated with midbrain atrophy, the atrophic midbrain and the rounded crust cerebri, they take the shape of a Mickey Mouse. So Mickey Mouse appearance on axial MRI brain suggests atrophic midbrain seen in cases of the progressive supranuclear palsy. The same atrophic midbrain on a sagittal MRI in a case of progressive supranuclear palsy gives the shape of a hummingbird or a penguin sign. So progressive supranuclear palsy on an axial MRI gives you Mickey Mouse appearance. On a sagittal MRI gives a hummingbird or a penguin sign. The next place where we encounter Mickey Mouse sign is at the anterior aspect of the thigh, at the region of the groin. On ultrasound at the anterior aspect of the thigh, the short axis ultrasound at the anterior aspect of the thigh, at the level of the groin, the arrangement of the femoral vessels, the femoral artery, the common femoral vein, and the opening of the great saphenous vein at the saphenofemoral junction takes the appearance of a Mickey Mouse. So this normal appearance of the femoral vessels at the level of the groin on ultrasound gives the appearance of a Mickey Mouse appearance. Another important site where I want you to remember this Mickey Mouse appearance is on a pelvic radiograph. On a pelvic radiograph, the outward flaring of the iliac wings, resembles the ears of a Mickey Mouse. So this outward flaring of the iliac wings seen associated with Down syndrome also resembles the Mickey Mouse ears. So this is another site where I want you to remember the Mickey Mouse appearance. So Mickey Mouse appearance on the pelvic radiograph is suggestive of Down syndrome. The other important place where I want you to remember the Mickey Mouse appearance is in bone scan. Bone scan, also called as bone scintigraphy, uses technetium 99M MDP, that stands for methylene diphosphonate. So on a bone scan, in Paget's disease, the increased uptake of technetium 99M in the vertebral body as well as the posterior elements of the vertebral body takes the shape of a Mickey Mouse. So basically in Paget's disease, we have an increased osteoblastic activity in the sclerotic phase of Paget's disease. You know, Paget's disease progresses through stages. There is a osteolytic phase, mixed phase, and a sclerotic phase. So when you have this increased osteoblastic activity in Paget's disease, there is increased uptake of technetium 99M MDP in the vertebral body, not just the vertebral body, but also on the posterior elements. And this appearance has been called as Mickey Mouse appearance on bone scan. So please remember, Mickey Mouse appearance on bone scan is feature of Paget's disease. The other important place where we encounter this Mickey Mouse sign is on the ultrasound liver and the biliary tree. On ultrasound liver, at the inferior aspect of the liver, at the porta hepatis, where we see the portal triad, where the portal vein and the hepatic artery are entering the liver and the common bile duct is exiting the liver, at this location on ultrasound liver, we see this appearance called as your Mickey Mouse appearance, where the portal vein forms the face of the Mickey Mouse, the common bile duct forms the right ear, as well as the hepatic artery that forms the left ear. So this appearance on ultrasound liver at the level of the porta hepatis, at the inferior aspect of liver, this is called as your Mickey Mouse sign. And the other site where we see a Mickey Mouse appearance is on an antenatal scan. On an antenatal scan, in a case of anencephaly, where you do not have a cranial vault, there is acrania. The appearance of the orbits take the shape of a frog eye appearance. This frog eye appearance or Mickey Mouse appearance is seen associated with anencephaly on a coronal image obtained on an ultrasound. So on an antenatal scan, on a coronal view, the appearance of the anencephalic baby, the appearance has been resembled to the frog eye appearance or the Mickey Mouse appearance. There are other sites also where you see this Mickey Mouse appearance. In pelvic junction obstruction on an ultrasound, the dilated pelvis and the calyceal system take the shape of the Mickey Mouse. So in pelvic junction obstruction, we'll not be able to see the ureter, but the dilated pelvis and the dilated calyces give the appearance of a Mickey Mouse. So this is a Mickey Mouse appearance in a pelvic junction obstruction on ultrasound. The other site where we see a Mickey Mouse appearance is on a chest radiograph. On a chest radiograph, in cases of bronchoceles, which are mucus-filled dilated bronchus, the appearance of these dilated bronchi can take the shape of finger-in-glove appearance, also called as Mickey Mouse appearance. So whenever we have this mucus plugging, distal to the obstruction, the bronchi dilate. And this dilation produces what is called as a finger-in-glove appearance or a Mickey Mouse appearance. So Mickey Mouse appearance or finger-in-glove appearance on chest radiograph is associated with bronchoceles. And bronchoceles and mucoceles can be seen in various conditions which can cause bronchial obstruction, like your bronchial hamartomas, bronchial masses compressing it, or in cases of aspergillosis, that is allergic bronchopulmonary aspergillosis. Also, we see this finger-in-glove appearances or a Mickey Mouse appearance on a chest radiograph. The other site where we can see a Mickey Mouse appearance is on axial imaging at the level of the pelvis or at the level of the bladder. So this is a CT scan image at the level of the bladder, and you can see that the bladder is distended and you can see the bladder showing herniation into the inguinal regions. So this inguinal vesicle hernia on an axial imaging takes the shape of a Mickey Mouse. So inguinal vesicle hernias can also show you this Mickey Mouse sign. So these are all the places where we see the Mickey Mouse sign in radiological imaging.